How do we understand the risk that is posed to the cyber assets that we have? So this is going to require that we understand the risk to the online information and the systems where it is stored and how they're connected and who they can be accessed by and things like that. So these kind of questions are exactly what we call developing a security mindset. A security mindset is really asking the kind of questions that I was just talking about. So if you say, well, what exactly, you know, how do you define a security mindset? You have to say, well, who are the bad actors? What can possibly they exploit? What vulnerabilities do I have? And if they're successful in exploiting a vulnerability, what is that attack going to be? So in the security mindset, the first thing we worry about is what is the threat source? In particular, who is the entity that wants to do us harm? So there are obviously these criminals who are in it for the money, professional criminals who want to profit from the data that they can steal. There's another sort of threat source people worry about. These are activists who use the internet, in particular hacking, that's why they're called hacktivists, and they have some sort of an agenda. People may agree with it or may not agree with it. When you sort of think about Snowden, well, he had an agenda. He didn't like certain things the U.S. government was doing. And that was the reason for him. It wasn't that he was trying to profit from the information that he took, but the reason really was activism. Finally, threats can come from nation states. And countries are actually doing this. They're doing it for political advantage. They're doing it for spying on each other. So the risk comes from sort of the threat source, sort of the entire spectrum from a set of group of criminals all the way to nation states. So threats are clearly very real.